So it'd be like if you're trying to throw out the garbage from your house and you just take everything out of the house, you take your furniture, you take all the curtains, you throw it all out on the curb, and then you take back everything except for that garbage bag. That's how the kidney actually works. My name is Beno Freedman. I'm an assistant professor at the University of Washington, and my lab studies kidney disease and regeneration using human pluripotent stem cells. One of the central problems that we're trying to solve is how to recreate the complexity of this organ so that we can regenerate tissues for people from their own bodies. Our hope is that if we start with pluripotent stem cells, we can actually generate tissues from those that will make a new kidney for people. The impact of the Allen iPS cell lines for our studies has been dramatic. Previously, it has not been possible for us to actually observe in real time what's happening inside the cell at a tissue level. See, right there, that's actually a cell division event captured in real time in a tissue. Another cell dividing right there. You can see they're very active. It's much easier to do now that we have the Allen cell lines, which are illuminating these different pieces or subcompartments of the cell. And for the first time, we've actually been able to generate kidney organoids using these cell lines. It opens up many options for us, both in understanding how the tissue functions, as well as potentially understanding how disease processes are working. And it's really amazing and beautiful to watch these individual subcompartments and organelles interact and move around in an intact tissue-like structure. That's really my hope. We need to get kidney replacement options on the table for everybody who needs them. The situation right now where people can't get the treatment they need is not acceptable. And it's going to be tremendous for the field. I do believe that this will become the flagship model for how we understand the cell.